At that time, it will be a time of intense pain and tribulation for the Ummah. And at that time, Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi will be there, and he will have been fighting against the forces of falsehood led by al-Masih al-Dajjal, the arch liar. The arch liar. That sums up the state of things at the end of times, the darkness that will prevail at that time, and the state in which the believers and those who stand for truth and haqq and goodness and uprightness and everything good, they will find themselves cornered. And yeah, they will be in dire straits and will be asking, as mentioned in the Holy Quran, of those who are also, you know, finding themselves in dire straits, but who are standing on the right, on the side of right and goodness, you say, Mata Nasrullah, when will the help come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But with sincere hearts, with penitent and repentant hearts, not with proud and doubtful hearts. So we must be careful when we supplicate. We should not come with preconditions, because cannot be shahad msharit, as they say. Beggars can't be choosy. The Arabic proverb also exists in English, that come, there's nothing more terrible, you know, more uglier than a proud beggar. No, we come, you know, beg humbly. We are at the door of the king, and it is up to him when he descends his help and his openings, his spiritual openings, and his relief from the state in which we find ourselves. So, in fact, we are nearest to our nurturing Lord when we are in difficulty, because that's when the time, when the heart really, with longing and with, can we say, yani, like the baby longing for their mother, And that is one of the meanings of ummah. Ummah from a community, a term for ummah, coming from the term meaning mother. And when we say al-rasul al-ummi, يعني which is usually translated as unlettered, not writing or reading, al-rasul al-ummi, it is also explained as the Rasul who depends on his Lord with complete and utter dependence and without any reservation, without any inkling of relying on himself. As we are raised to rely on ourselves, but dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reverses that until the point that when we see ourselves at the end of our rope, but depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a whole new set of calculation. We see ourselves completely destitute, but with Allah, Allah's economy is something completely different. Dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a hoop of steel binding our heart and giving us strength beyond calculation, beyond any estimation. So that is what we call barakah, the blessing from above, pouring down on us, just like this blessed rain that we are witnessing, soft, constant, life-giving rain on our hearts, whether we feel it or not. So, someone with a little bit of food might find that they are happier and more sated than someone with all kinds of colors and dishes, and healthier too, and stronger. So, that is madad. When we ask for madad, help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, spiritual support from His friends, prophets and saints, those that Allah brings near, is life worth living if we are not in such a state? Are we only animals? No. So we have been given something. I've been given something, and we have been made part of this ummah, the last ummah, the best ummah, the ummah where Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam coming down from the heaven, supported by the angels as iqama, the call to prayer that we have just heard, and alhamdulillah we responded, may Allah accept from all of us, ameen. We'll be raised, and it will be dawn, the dawn prayer, the fajr time in the great mosque of Damascus at the white minaret. So goes the hadith to that effect, the Prophet ﷺ predicting that this event will take place. And Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, being the great prophet that he is, will be asked by Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi, the descendant of the Holy Prophet ﷺ, will be representing the side of goodness and truth. He will be asked, Ya Ruh Allah, O spirit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that spirit of life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created with kun fayakun, be and it is, without the help of ways and means and natural causes that we all know and we all go through, such as a father and the father's, cohabitation with the mother. No, with the order kun fayakun. And as mentioned in the Holy Quran, you say, if they ask you about Isa, those who claim that and he must be the son of God. No, if they ask you about him, say that his example is as the example of Adam, who not only has no father, but no mother as well. And Allah created him with kun fayakun. Be and it was. Be and it came to be. Allahu Akbar. So, and that is the meaning of ruhun minhu. Yani a spirit, yani a spirit of life, coming to life from the direct command of Allah, from the amr of Allah, the amr that dominates and controls all creation. Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir. So the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Imam al-Baydawi said that it does not mean that Allah must automatically have to say the words even kun. No, it just means that as quick as you can imagine that yourself saying these two letters, the kaf and the noon, his command is faster than that. Subhanalladhi amruhu bayna al-kafi wal-noon. Glory to the one whose command and order is between the kaf and the noon of kun, be. As you would say, between the B and the E in English. But in between, yani faster than that. That's what it means. Faster yet. So, that is Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam and Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. Two immense prophets that we are connected to. So, and Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi alayhi salam will say to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Ya Ruhallah, taqaddam, be our Imam, O Spirit from Allah. And Sayyidina Isa will reply, Laka uqimat, for you the iqama was made, therefore you, and because Sayyidina Isa will be so, and Allah knows best, but so happy that this is the moment when my request to be part of the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad SAW, this is happening now. It is now realized and fulfilled. My request has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am part of the Ummah. And to show this, that although he's still a prophet, Allah did not take back that rank from him, but he is part of the Ummah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to show to all of his followers also that if you love me and you want to follow me, follow that prophet because I am following him. I am giving salam to him. I am submitting and believing in him and saying la ilaha ashhadu an la ilaha illallah ashhadu anna muhammadan rasulullah. So he will pray behind Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi. And then after that, after Salat, they will rise and he will ask, so point me to your issue that you are having trouble with. And say, that is, those are over there, the sides of those who are assailing us, those who want us harm, those who want to bring falsehood on earth and to make the reign of falsehood reign. And rule, and Sayyidina Isa at that time will take up his spear that they will give to him, and he will go and kill the Masih al-Dajjal. And after he kills the Masih al-Dajjal, he will show on the spear, he will show it up to show what? The blood on the spear, to prove to the people that this Masih al-Dajjal, the arch liar, the one that they call in English Antichrist, is not a god because he bleeds. The hadith also says that Masih al-Dajjal will die even before Isa reaches him, because as soon as he sees Sayyidina Isa, he will melt like salt in water of fear, because falsehood cannot stand long. The batil cannot be, yani, cannot stand long. When haq appears, when truth appears, batil must dissolve. So, but that will be, have to be done like that. You have to kill him and show to the people the blood on the spear. And this is an illusion and a sign also, as the ulama said, that Sayyidina Isa also is saying, how can also I be called what some of my followers called me? To be God or son of God, because a God does not grow tired. A God does not have to sleep. A God does not have to eat. And the other thing, after eating. And so this is the meaning also of that verse, that Isa and his mother, they used to eat. See, so this is also a euphemism to understand that if they used to eat, that means they also used to go where, as they say, even the king must go, since they are human beings. And growing old, and one of the signs also of growing old, وَيُكَلِّمُ النَّاسِ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. That's another proof. He shall speak to people from the cradle. When Sayyidina Isa was announced, the news of Sayyidina Isa to Sayyida Maryam, alayhim as-salam, and the angels or angel was saying to Sayyida Maryam that Allah is giving you the glad tidings of Isa, and he shall speak to people from the cradle and kahlan, and as a mature man. And kuhula starts at age 30 in Arabic nomenclature. Kahl, we say sheikh, yani an older man. See, there's the kahl and the sheikh. Example, mashallah. So, and that's a sign that that he cannot be a god. So God does not grow older. Be first in the cradle, and then a kahl. What's next? Wrinkles and yeah. So many signs, and that is one of the signs. And Sayyidina Isa himself, and at that time, many also will enter Islam, and they will all be following in his wake. And we, when we speak of Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam, this is what we mean, that we are wanting until the last of our lives and until the last of the ages of this creation, if Allah grants us to live up to that time, because we don't know whether it is in our lifetime, it might well be, because things, we are not in control of how fast things are changing and in what way. And what we have seen of strangest things lately, this stranger is yet to come. Stranger than fiction, as they say. And the flag of falsehood that is being raised now, yani, is everywhere. Without shame even. As if it was something funny or light, that yes, fake news, yes, but to feed to the people and let them deal with that, everyone, not thinking of what effect that has on the way we raise our children and our ethics as speakers of truth. So we stand for truth. Prophets stand for truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stands for truth. His books stand for truth. That is the meaning of Allah is Nur. Allah is light. Prophets are light. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is light. Quran is light. And all the heavenly books, Torah, Injil, Zabur, light. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِّنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُّبِينٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing the Bani Israel, the Holy Quran, saying, now a prophet has come to you, and light of the Holy Prophet. So the Nur of Prophet is mentioned in the Holy Quran, because the massive majority of the Mufassirun said that the light here is referring to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Kitab al-Mubin, a clear book, the Holy Quran. So that is what it means to be believing in Sayyidina Mahdi alayhi salam, just as we believe in the other signs of the rising of the final hour. Yani the signs that are like prefigure the day of resurrection. And among them, the spread of falsehood, but that is a sign also that the truth is going to rise again and triumph. Because all prophets came in such difficult times, times of darkness. And prophets appear at that time, and truth triumphs again. So we are one in that, in our intention to be on the side of truth. And this is the intention, the reason why we follow shuyukh and teachers of guidance. Teachers of guidance that are reminding us of the times in which we live, and that are paying special attention and teaching us to pay special attention to such hadiths, about the hadiths of the end of times, when truth will be called falsehood, falsehood will be called truth, and you will see all kinds of strange signs of pride among people, and of massive changes also, that the Prophet ﷺ said that such that the person who is considered a believer will be going to bed a believer but rising a disbeliever. Subhanallah. And he said also at that time, the one who keeps fast to their belief and their religion, at that time it will be more difficult than to hold on to a live coal. Who can hold on to a live coal? So it will be also almost against reason, you see. That's the effort that will be asked of the believer. Because it would not be reasonable to hold on to a live coal, you'll be told to let go of it. He said, you know, save yourself. So, subhanallah. And the Prophet ﷺ also said that to his companions, you live in a time when if you leave one thing out of 10 orders and commands, then you will be in trouble. But they will live in a time when if they keep fast to one command out of 10, they will be safe. And whoever revives one of my sunnahs in that time will have the reward of a shaheed. And in another version, 70 shaheed, meaning unlimited. 70 being the number of yani vast and unlimited in Arabic. Inshallah. So, and finally, in this hadith that the Prophet ﷺ also mentioned, he said, my ummah, my community, this blessed community of Islam, where I am bringing the conclusion and the final seal of all of the heavenly books, containing them all and confirming them all. Said the blessing of that ummah is such that he said, it is like the rain. Again, you see that symbol of life-giving rain. And you know the name for rain in Arabic, one of the many names for rain is ghaith. The ghaith. Ghaith is like help and mercy. All of that is in that name for, that term for rain. He said that ummati kal ghaith. Mathalu ummati kamathalil ghaith. That the similitude of my ummah is as the rain. لا يعلم أوله خير أم آخره. Yani you do not know whether the beginning of the rain is the best part or the end of it is the best yet. Yani there's more goodness to come yet. And this is immense humbleness on the part of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say, though he is at the beginning and the Sahaba, the best of times, he's saying, yet there is something even of comparable goodness that is coming at the end. And he's referring to that time of the triumph of truth against falsehood in the darkest of times, at the end of times. And after all of these tyrannical and terrible events that will be happening and causing people to suffer and despair, yet there will be Sayyidina Isa, there will be Al-Mahdi, there will be the believers, there will be the support and the help of Allah. Mata Nasrullah, Nasrullah is coming. Help from Allah is coming, so do not despair and be happy and think, just as the Khilafah of Nubuwa, as the Prophet ﷺ termed the first government of or the first community around the Holy Prophet ﷺ, was the best of communities with the rightly guided Khulafa, Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali radiallahu anhum, around the Prophet ﷺ. And he said, after that, and things will decline. And then until, complete tyranny, then he said the model of prophethood will come back again. And he's referring to that time, the kingdom of Sayyidina Al-Mahdi, alayhi salam. He actually called it a kingdom. Yeah. And of divine support, of belief in truth, in right, in goodness and practice, will come back, and that is when the end of the, as if we are again living in the time of the Sahaba al-Kiram. And Hakim al-Tirmidhi, one of the earliest Sufis, who was a great influence of Sheikh Muhyiddin ibn Arabi, who commented on many of Hakim al-Tirmidhi's writing. Hakim al-Tirmidhi in the mid-third century Hijri, he said that it is almost as if saying that there will be types of the caliber of the Khulafa al-Rashidin even at the end of times. Like Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam, being the higher rank of Sayyidina al-Mahdi. And of course Sayyidina Isa, then Haddith wa la Haraj. Of course, he is being a prophet, that is well known to everyone. But among the awliya, the non-prophet awliya, then Sayyidina Al-Mahdi and those with him and those with Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, until they are taken back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are taken back miraculously, subhanallah. After a long life that Allah will grant Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, and in some reports that he will marry, because he was devoted to worship and did not marry in his life. When he was first sent, and he was happy to be just worshipping his Lord all the time. Now, Imam al-Junaid, radiallahu anhu, Junaid al-Baghdadi, one of the great awliya, and who is in the silsila of most of the tariqas, he said that he took to fasting so intensely, since an early age. His uncle, I think it was his uncle, Sari al-Saqati, influencing him as he would see him pray at night, and try to imitate him, and so forth, being with his Lord all the time. So Junaid al-Baghdadi said, I came to a point when I was fasting non-stop. Allah granted him that. You see, those awliya, that not out of pride or out of to vaunt or to boast or anything like that, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, come near, bringing them nearer and giving them the strength to stay up, to not eat, to, so even for days on end, non-stop, without breaking the fast. He said, until Allah gave me to fast non-stop for 27 days, he said. 27 days. And there is a report of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was weeping. He was weeping one day, and he was asked, Ya Ruh Allah, why are you weeping? He said, because I have to break my fast now. I've been fasting for 40 days. He said, Allahu Akbar. This is in the Islamic sources. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.
Amen.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be with His holy ones in dunya and in akhirah. To be, not to be left to ourselves, because ourselves we are given to despair. And we are given to be too perplexed, or to be fed up, or to be angry, or to be tired, or to be whatnot. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah can change us. Allahumma hawwil halana ila ahsani hal, zahiran wa batinan. Allah can give us a sustenance that defies description of palpable and impalpable. Hissan wa ma'nan. And rizq hasan. Allahumma rizqna rizqan hasanan, halalan, tayyiban, كافيا شافيا واسعا وأغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وأغننا بك عن الناس. Allah, change us into the best state in dunya and in akhirah, and do not leave us to ourselves, and keep us with the sadiqeen. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. And grant us to remember you with our tongues and with our hearts, with our states, with our actions, with our statements. And as we sleep and as we wake, as we travel and as we are at home, and Ya Rabbi, take us back to you safe and sound from the fitna and strife of this dunya, on the path of those whom you have favored, among prophets, among siddiqs, the greatest saints, and among martyrs, and among the righteous, the salihin, wa hasuna ulaika rafiqa, and that is the best company in dunya and in akhirah. ومن الله سبحانه وتعالى التوفيق حرمة الحبيب حرمة الفاتحة. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله
وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أشهد أن